In the last video, I showed you some ways you can use VST plugins in OBS Studio to process and improve your audio. Today, I'm showing you a similar ability, but applied to your face cam or other video footage through the use of LUTs, or lookup tables. This is actually pretty cool. Let's take a look right after this. TunnelBear is the fast and easy VPN service that keeps your data safe and secure behind a bear. Sign up for your 7-day free trial and learn more via the link in the video description. I'm Eeples Fox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. I've got plenty of these episodes linked in the video description down below. Check them out if you have any questions, and otherwise, let's jump in, shall we? Color lookup tables are used to take an image and adjust its color information based on the value in the lookup table. Applied to OBS, it will basically apply some cool color filtering to your webcam or other video input. Linked in the video description, I have a specific webcam LUT included for download, as well as a website that offers a few for free. Try them out and see if you like them. OBS Studio also includes some sample LUTs in the install directory under obs-studio/data/obs-plugins/obs-filters/LUTs. You can see it on screen. I can't say it right. These are PNG files. The posterized LUT applies a kind of like comic book effect. Black and white is, well, obvious. Red isolated only shows shades of red, turning everything else black and white. Teal lows, orange highs applies the cliche cinema effect of bluish shadows and orangish highlights. Kind of a neat look. The one I included in the description does a similar effect, but retains more of the original coloring too. What's neat is that you can easily make your own. The original.png included with OBS is a default LUT. Apply your color correction presets to this PNG via your favorite photo editor, and be sure to save it as a new file so you can make new ones later, and apply it to your webcam. But what about the other ones I linked in the description? The freebies, and most LUTs that you download, come zipped up as a .cube file. OBS won't accept that. You need to use a program like Adobe Photoshop to apply it to a copy of the original.png file. Copy your desired .cube, .3dl, or .look files into the appropriate preset folder directory for Photoshop. For me, that's C, Program Files, Adobe, Adobe Photoshop CC 2017, Presets, 3D LUTs. Relaunch Photoshop if you had it open, and drag a copy of original.png into it. Now go to Image, Adjustments, and Color Lookup. Here, click the drop-down menu next to the 3D LUT file, and choose the file you copied over. For whatever reason, it won't let me browse for other LUTs outside of that folder, which is why you need to copy it. Click OK, and watch as the image file changes. Now save this as the name of the LUT, .png. For example, for me, this will be aspen.png. Now you can use it in OBS by copying it to the directory and apply it to your webcam or gameplay if you want. This can be great for basic things such as adjusting contrast and saturation or applying crazy effects to your footage. You can also apply multiple LUTs to one source. It just will get messy after you lather on the effects. Do you have a favorite LUT? Share in the comments below. I hope this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it was, hit that like button, get subscribed for more awesome tech videos. If you like game streaming, come follow me on Twitch and drop a message in chat. Until next time, I'm Eeples Fox. Happy streaming.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full masterclass are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/eeplesfox to sign up.